We stand today at the threshold of a great event, both in the life of the United Nations and in the life of mankind. This Universal Declaration of Human Rights may well become the international Magna Carta.
The world can thank a daughter of India, Dr. Hansa Mehta, for replacing the phrase in the Universal Declaration of Human Rights. It said, all men are born free and equal. Now it's changed, all human beings are born free and equal.
The dynamics in the United Nations changes radically during the years 1946 to 48, in which the Universal Declaration of Human Rights is being drafted, debated, and voted through different bodies in the United Nations. At the outset, the United States and France, they place a strong emphasis on earlier notions of the rights of man, articulated in their respective constitutions. India had already been a member of the United Nations by 1945 and had voted for the charter that same year. But while gaining full independence in 1947, India sends a delegate to the Commission on Human Rights, famous for having presented the national flag that same year on behalf of the women of India, Hansa Mehta. Eleanor Roosevelt has not reacted to the use of rights of man in the initial drafts, which is now brought to debate by Hansa Mehta. The preamble of the first draft reads, quote, "The General Assembly," and this might have been your preamble, "recognizing the fact that the United Nations has been established for the specific purpose of enthroning the natural rights of man to freedom and equality before the law and for upholding the worth and dignity of human personality," end quote. Hansa Mehta, the only female delegate in the Commission on Human Rights besides Eleanor Roosevelt, objects to the use of man in the draft, arguing that member states can use this to restrict women's rights rather than expand them, since women are not necessarily regarded as included by that wording.
One other person that was such a big influence on Eleanor Roosevelt was India's Hansa Mehta. For the Universal Declaration of Human Rights, it was Hansa Mehta who said, "Excuse me, Mrs. Roosevelt, if you say all men are created free and equal, around the world it will be all men, women not included." And so the words were changed to all human beings. That small change has had a tremendous impact. Women will be included everywhere, all human beings, men and women and children, have these rights.